Hello everyone, welcome to my free online tutorial for the new SAT math section. Now the problem that you see on your screen right now is taken from the new SAT, the official SAT study guide just released by a college board. As you know, it contains four practice exams, and this problem that you see is taken from the first exam in section 3, where calculator is not allowed, and this is problem number 13. Okay, practice exam 1, section 3, problem 13. Now it asks you to simplify the given expression, and the given expression is sort of a complex fraction, because we have a sum of two fractions expressed as a denominator of a larger fraction, the parent fraction. Okay, so you need to simplify this to make it look like one of these. So how do we do that? The easiest way to approach this problem is to get rid of this fraction in the denominator, the smaller fraction, right? And how do we do that? We got to get rid of these, the x plus 2 and x plus 3. So if we find the lowest common denominator, right, for these small denominators, right, then we can get rid of the fraction, so of these smaller denominators. So we have to multiply this fraction, the parent fraction, by the LCD of the denominator, right? Now the LCD, I'm talking about the denominator, the lowest common denominator for these two fractions, the smaller fractions, right? And the lowest common denominator would be the product of these two small denominators, which is x plus 2 and x plus 3. So you have to multiply these two, and this product here, x plus 3 times x plus 2, will be the lowest common denominator for these two smaller fractions. Okay, because the numerator is 1, and the second numerator is 1 for the two smaller fractions, and you need the lowest common denominator for them. So you multiply this whole parent fraction, right, by the lowest common denominator for the two smaller fractions, and you have to multiply both sides. You have to multiply the numerator of the parent fraction and the whole denominator by the lowest common denominator of the two smaller fractions. Because if you just multiply the numerator of the parent one, it won't look like it never existed, right? Because if you multiply both the numerator and the denominator, it will equal 1. Because this whole thing is multiplied by the imaginary 1, right? It's just not written there. Anything times 1 is itself. That's why whatever we do to the numerator must be also done to the denominator, in order to not violate the concept of not changing anything, right? So you are going to change something, but in order for this fraction to keep the quantity that it represents, you must do the same thing. Whatever it is that you're trying to do to the numerator, you have to do the same thing to the denominator. So we're going to multiply both the numerator of the parent fraction by the lowest common denominator of the two smaller fractions here, and we're going to multiply this whole denominator by the lowest common denominator of the two smaller fractions, right? So what happens here? Here we have this result shown, so it's very convenient for you to see, right? This is the parent fraction, so we're going to multiply both the numerator of this parent fraction and the denominator of this parent fraction by the lowest common denominator of the two smaller fractions here, because they're being added. That's why we have to find the lowest common denominator. So when we do that, the numerator simply becomes itself, which is x plus 3 times x plus 2, and the denominator is a little bit more complicated, because we have to follow the distributive property. First of all, take a look at this. We have to distribute this multiplier to this fraction, smaller fraction, and to this smaller fraction. And when we do that, x plus 2 will be cancelled out, because x plus 2 multiplies this smaller fraction here. So x plus 2 cancel out, and we have remaining x plus 3. in place of this first fraction. So x plus 3, and then we're going to keep adding, right? Because it's still a sum. The sum never goes away. We can never avoid the sum. The sum is still there, so we're going to keep adding. So what happens to the second smaller fraction? The second smaller fraction has x plus 3 canceling out, because x plus 3 is on the top, and when you divide x plus 3 by x plus 3, it's going to be gone. It's just going to be 1. Right, so x plus 2 remains for the second smaller fraction. So x plus 3 remains for the first smaller fraction, and x plus 2 remains for the second smaller fraction. Right, so we have a simple sum after that. X plus 3 plus x plus 2. And what happens after that? We have to distribute using the FOIL method in order to create a polynomial, so to speak, which is going to be x squared plus 5x plus 6. For the numerator. And for the denominator, we just combine the like terms, which is going to be x plus x, which is 2x, and 3 plus 2 is equal to 5. So this is our ultimate answer, and this is the same quantity. Remember that this is the same quantity as the original parent fraction that was given to us in this question, right? We just rewrote it. We wrote it in a simpler way. We wrote it in a way in which we can only deal with the numerator, basically, and the denominator. Because here, as you see, there was a numerator, but there was a parent fraction, and there were also two smaller fractions inside of this parent fraction, right? It just makes your eye a little bit uncomfortable. You need to really simplify it to make things look really more pleasant in a way, right? So this is a pleasant kind of way of showing this original expression. Okay, and this answer, if you can search it here, you will find that choice B shows this exact result that we just found. X squared plus 5x plus 6 over 2x plus 5.